And we're live.
Hey, welcome to Show and Tell with the Two Mortgage Guys. We come to you live every Tuesday at noon on Facebook and YouTube.
We're going to do something a little different today. And Steve and I are going to talk about some different loan products you might not be too familiar with. We're going to cover reverse mortgages, manufactured homes, renovation lending. And we're going to give you a quick update on what rates are doing. Stick around. All right. So, hey, also, we're live. So if anyone's actually watching this live, if you've got a question about mortgage lending in general or any of the products we're talking about, just type in the comments, and we'll do our best to answer your questions for you right here. But we wanted to kind of go over some stuff that we don't, that probably products that maybe not everybody really knows a lot about, and something that's we think a fantastic product that we have on our menu. That a lot of lenders do not is reverse mortgages.
So reverse.
How cool are reverse mortgages, Steve?
Yeah, they're, people just don't understand them. That's the problem. But it's, in short terms, it's basically a home equity loan with an FHA. It's government insured. They've been doing them for years and years and years, and you can get some money out of your house. The big thing is, with reverse mortgages is just how much equity you have available. That's the key to it, really.
And if you've never even heard of a reverse mortgage, in essence, it's the reason it's called reverse mortgages. You don't make a payment. You actually either receive money on a monthly basis or you get a lump sum. And what's happening is you're accumulating interest every month instead of making a payment and having your balance go down. Interest is tacked on. So the amount you owe goes up, but you never make a payment. So if you're sitting on a bunch of equity, you spent your whole life making payments on your mortgage and you've paid it off or you've paid down the majority of it, it's a way for you to get your hands on some of that money without that payment that comes with it with traditional financing.
Exactly. And it's the same point, even if you have a balance on your mortgage, if it's a low enough balance, it can actually pay that off and give you a little bit of cash back and still not have a mortgage payment. There's just tons of ins and outs. Ryan and I have dabbled in reverse mortgages for years where we've been in and out looking at stuff on them.
We tried this in the past. We really tried to kind of promote reverse mortgages specifically in this marketplace, and it's so misunderstood. People think that the bank gets their house if they die. They don't understand it, right? They are against it before they ever even really truly consider their options because it's so commonly misunderstood in this market. And in some places, I mean, they're using reverse mortgages left and right. But I'll give you an example. So without saying names, I know somebody that is retired. Okay. And the two of them have retirement income. So pension, Social Security, their home is almost paid for and they have all this equity in their home. And at some point they're going to die. Right. And that equity then is going to be left to their children. And they're cool with that. They want that. And the kids obviously would take the equity as well. But meanwhile, the parents aren't really able with their current income to go out and do things they want to do. They can't really travel. They can't do some of that stuff. And although they want to help their kids when they die, they don't necessarily need to give them all that equity.
Right.
And they don't want to do traditional financing because they don't want that payment. Because if they did a cash out refi, for example, and we gave them $100,000, they'd have this massive payment with it. And with the reverse, they could get their hands on
15 or 30 years. They'd be making that payment
for 30 years. Exactly. So with the reverse product, they're able to get money back at closing. They can do their traveling. They can do all the things that they can't fit into their budget. They have no payment. And guess what? So now they just have a mortgage. So now when they die, the kids are still going to get equity in their home after paying the mortgage off. And that's no different than if they had a regular mortgage, right? I mean, If somebody has a traditional mortgage today and they die, that mortgage has to be paid off and the equity goes to the kids. So it's the exact same thing.
Right.
Hey, it's just a unique way of getting it.
Carrie asked on that about the age requirement. So yes, 62 and older is FHA. There are some other investors that do reverse mortgages. They've got different platforms that'll go down to 55. There's different guidelines for them, but the traditional one that was, they call it a reverse mortgage. They changed the name to it to HECM, which is a home equity COM. Yeah. So it's a home equity credit line is what it is. So they changed the name because they just thought it reversed. But it's just, I had somebody tell me when Ryan and I were doing this years ago that said, it's the only difference is everybody, most everybody is a forward mortgage. We're making payments forward on it. A reverse is just opposite. You get your money, but you don't have to make a payment on it. So.
And the other interesting thing about reverse is you're not able to get all the equity. Okay. There's no scenario that somebody's pulling out all their equity and then dying and then the house isn't worth it. You're maxed out on a traditional at 40% of the value of your home. So you still have more than half of the value left in equity. And then think about this, your home value is going up, right? What are home values doing? Like, look at the last 2 years. We've had crazy home appreciation.
Right.
So you go pull money out of your house, and then 3 years later, first off, your house is worth more money. So even though that your balance went up because of the accrued interest, the value of your home went up as well. So it's just such a cool, crazy, unique way to get your hands on that equity and offset or add to your retirement income to get you able to do things in retirement years that you couldn't do otherwise. It's just a fantastic product. I'm just going to say, exactly. If you know somebody, if it's a parent, if you've got parents, neighbors, anybody you know that you think could use that extra income to supplement their lifestyle that either has a mortgage that's really low on their home or doesn't owe anything at all, have them get a hold of us. I mean, we're happy to explain to them. It's not like we can just, they have to go through education. There's a whole process involved, but.
Yeah, it's detailed. They can't even do the loan application most of the time until they have some type of HUD counseling, housing and urban development. So they got to talk to somebody that is very familiar with this from housing and urban development. And they got to go through the process, make sure they know that they understand everything that's involved with it. So it is detailed. It's extremely safe on it. And the other point, Ryan, that works really well on reverse mortgages, too, is a lot of times is people get older, they want to help their children and grandchildren, and this is another way you can do it because you can tap into some of that equity that would be there later on in life and be able to give it to your kids and grandkids and see them enjoy it at a younger age. So
good point, paying for college, right? Vehicles, it's a way for them to get their hands on some money without having a payment come with it.
Yep, we've seen.
We could go on and on about this. It's really a fantastic product. We just want you guys to understand something that we have. We offer it. We know what we're doing with this program. Reach out to us.
Right.
We want to talk about renovation loans. This is another one of those products that not every lender offers or not everybody realizes it's an option. But we do have people ask all the time, hey, can I buy a house and then can I borrow extra money so I can fix it? And there is a way to do that. There are some renovation products that allow you to do that. So we'll share a couple of those today, the FHA version and then the home style conventional version.
Right. Yeah. So I just had a call yesterday with a guy that's looking at a property and it's in Kokomo. It's 50 grand. It's not much, but the reason it is it needs all kinds of TLC. So he had some pictures. He emailed me of the house. In order for him to get it, it's going to have to be renovated. It's got bad windows, peeling paint. It needs some work done to it. But the great thing with the FHA 203K is they have the streamlined version, which is mainly for like renovations and updates. And then they have the full. If you have to go in and do major work to the house, move walls or structural stuff, you can do it either way with it. So, and we're well versed in that. Ryan and I have been doing these for close to 20 years.
Quite a while. I did a renovation loan once for a good client of mine. Had a daughter with some special needs. She needed wheelchair access throughout the house. So they found a property that was perfect for them, but they had some doorways that needed widening, some ramps that were built up. And this allowed them to buy the home and borrow additional money to make all those renovations possible, right? So that was a cool, unique way of doing it. And then I did a loan once for a person that bought a home that the value was there, but it needed some major work. And they could see, they had a vision of what this house would be like if they could completely redo the kitchen. They did a painting, did flooring. I mean, they pretty much totally redid this house, and they financed everything together. And in the simplest form, on like a streamlined renovation loan, is you can add up to $30,000. Technically, it's a little bit more than that. We cap it at $30,000 because we want to leave a little bit of wiggle room in there in case something unexpected comes up. But imagine $30,000 worth of renovations and what that could do to any home that you may have looked at recently. Because if you're out there in the market and you're looking at real estate today and you've already got thin inventory, you're probably walking in some of these homes and going, oh my God, am I back in 1979?
Right.
Because the market's full of them. And they have good bones and they look nice on the outside, but they're super dated. And it's just going to take, it's amazing what $20,000 can do to making a home look a lot nicer and newer. So it's a way of accomplishing that without having to have all that money saved up.
Right. Like you said, one of the pieces of the puzzle is the appraisal. Like you said earlier, sometimes you can buy a house under value and you've got room to work with it. So an appraiser is involved with the renovation loans, where they're going to actually look at the house and give you an as is value and then a subject to completion once the work's completed on it. So they've got to make sure it's going to appraise before you get too far into the process. Because you can't go through and basically redo the whole thing and make it a $200,000 house if your neighborhood average is 120. So that's one of the things to look at. But we've not really ever ran into that. I think most all the time we've looked at doing these on refinances or purchases, it's worked well.
Yeah. There's things you can't do. Once again, lots to cover. So if you think that you've got a home that could use some renovation, this could be an angle for you. Or if you're out shopping and you've had that experience where you found some homes that you like, but they were a little too dated and you just didn't want to buy them because you didn't have the ability to renovate them, this could be for you. Just reach out to us. We'll answer any specific questions. We can kind of fill you in on the criteria. It's not for everyone. It's not the cheapest loan program. I mean, honestly, the costs are a little bit higher. There's more expenses. There's more processes involved. This cannot be do-it-yourself work. You have to have a contractor doing the actual renovations. But I tell you what, it's a great program for the right person.
Hey,
What's that?
Like a favorite that I like working, that we've done some of these on in the past after, you know, renovations that we get finished up with them, is manufactured housing. I mean, that for a while almost disappeared. I don't know, 2010 or 11. But Ryan and I did manufactured home loans from 2004 until the collapse of the economy. And then we've done them again since then. So it's one of those things that's on our menu. There's not a lot of lenders out there that do them. So we in-house underwrite these loans. So it's one of those things that we're going to look at and follow through and find out. There's all kinds of stuff. And Ryan can hit on this. It's the HUD tags. There's these tags that get covered up over years or get missing, and it's hard to locate them. And then you have to go through and try to get an IBTS report from the Bureau of Motor Vehicles, and cumbersome. But we've got all the pieces of the puzzle laid out online or in person that we can get the information to let the seller know what they got to do to get the proper tags and documentation.
And the first thing I would say about manufactured homes is you need to understand there is a difference. And a lot of times people don't understand that financing a manufactured home is different than a traditional, what they call a stick-built property. Okay. Even if they're put on a permanent foundation, it's just at one time it was literally treated like a vehicle. Okay. And then it likely got put on a permanent foundation, but these are things that we have to make sure have happened. That it was deeded correctly and that it's mounted securely to the ground, that somebody can't come steal it, right? That's right. Why the risk level is different from a lending perspective. And I would caution you that if you're doing it, look at manufactured housing, understand that you need to let your lender know that. Hopefully it's us. If it's somebody else, let them know it's a manufactured home, because they might not be able to do the loan otherwise. Like Steve mentioned, those tags. I hope those tags are there, because if the tags aren't available on the home because they've been removed, that can complicate and delay things. But otherwise, it's possible you can find a manufactured home, get a loan on it like normal, move in. It's a great property. And it seems like in Indiana, there's a lot of these. There's a lot of them. Yeah. They're nice. They're not like they're dumps. I mean, there's some really nice manufactured homes sitting on multiple acres of property out in the country.
Well, septics, nice. Outbuildings. We've seen a lot of them that are, and they're pretty high dollar on it. And we can do these with Fannie Mae. So conventional with FHA government and with VA. We actually just closed a manufactured VA loan. I think it was in June or July. So
What's the neighborhood outside of town we went through, and they have brand new ones in there. Really nice.
Right.
We you remember that there. Name of
yeah,
it?
There, yeah.
What's the street that's on over by Ivy Tech? Past Ivy
Tech.
Yeah,
that's Morgan Street, and it's 250 North, right out in that direction. That is that housing addition.
So they're putting brand new ones out there, and we went through one, and I'm telling you, it was crazy nice on the inside. It did not what you're picturing in your head when you think manufactured. It didn't feel like that at all.
Right.
It was pretty wide. It was neat property.
And it's good. They're building it into like a neighborhood. So you're not stacked on top of each other. You got a little bit of property in between you. So gets you a little bit more affordability out in that country area. It's yet still close to town. That's one of the unique things about manufactured housing.
Well, we can do them. So if you come across a manufactured home you can't live without, we'd love to help. Let's spend a couple seconds on interest rates. We weren't going to get all crazy and show you pie charts or anything, but I think the general consensus that we're getting from the experts that we follow is that hopefully the signs are kind of reading that we've kind of peaked out. Hopefully we've peaked out rates for 2022. So if you've been following the interest rates this year, you've seen crazy increase. I mean, Steve, you can say neither one of us have seen rates move this quickly in such a short period of time. I mean, it's unbelievable. Right. We've shifted 3% in 6 months, and that's just nuts. But the good news is it looks like maybe we've kind of hit that ceiling, if you will. We've had some, like today was better than yesterday as far as rates go, a little bit. So hopefully we've kind of peaked out on these rates, and we hold steady, or maybe we even see a little bit of a dip.
Yeah. And from, you know, like Ryan said, we've got some mortgage gurus that we've followed. We've been doing this for 20 years. So we're following people that's been doing it longer than us that are really, really good at reading some of this stuff. And it's like Ryan said. So if everything's happening right now, it's a little less right now than what it was, you know, 2-3 weeks ago. And when I'm saying a little less, you're still in the high 5%, but it's not bad. I mean, I looked at a chart earlier today that they were showing all the way back from 1981 at 18% interest rates, and then how they dipped down. I bought my house in 89, my very first house, 10.75%. And then I refinanced that thing 3 or 4 times and got down to like 6 point something. So that's one of the things you got to sort of look at in that same thing is, you know, rates may stay at this for a while. And if they do, that's okay. They're eventually going to drop back down sometime. And historically, it always shows it.
We were 8.5% on our first house. And I remember being excited about that.
Yeah.
It's all perspective. It's all what you're used to seeing. And if you've been looking at real estate or thinking about real estate in the last 6-7 years, you just haven't seen rates like this. But they're still pretty good. And then the other thing too, the nice benefit of working with us, I mean, I know how we operate and what we do with our clients, and we monitor interest rates for our clients. We have really good software technology that will prompt us if market rates dip below a certain amount so that we can reach out to our clients and say, hey, there could be an opportunity here to save you some money. So right now, this year specifically, we're setting up a lot of the people that we're helping buy homes with the possibility that there could be a dip in the market, and there probably will be, because everything kind of does this, and we'll be reaching out to those clients to hopefully save them some money if we get an interest rate drop. We just don't know if it's going to happen for sure. We don't know when. It could be 3 months from now. It could be 2 years from now.
Yeah, that's the thing, is nobody really ever knows. So if they don't, the only thing you can do is just trust somebody. And look, we've been doing this for a long time and it's for a reason. We like doing it, and we're going to follow up, make sure everybody gets taken care of with it. So
absolutely.
Right. So, Ryan, you got anything else before we wrap up or?
No, I think that's good for this week.
We're going to try to do this, throughout some of that. I have to guess on it and sometimes just try to come back up with the topic. So we'll maybe try to throw something out and see if somebody's got some ideas and they can get it back on. So if you guys, you know, before we say goodbye, if you liked it, share it, comment. And then if you've got a topic that you've got questions on, or if it's one of these after the live, just put it in there. We'll respond back out to it. So thanks for tuning in.
Next week, we're going to be interviewing Chris Mullinax from CRM Properties. Chris offers a wealth of information about buying investment properties, rental income, property management, and home renovations. Be sure to tune in next Tuesday at noon.